Why did you come for me?
Those who enslaved you, killed our leader, and banished us from our land. Join us, and we will have our revenge.
47 Ronin is based on a real story.
Their army is infinite. We are 47.
This story is the most famous samurai story in Japan.
Here, you have the tradition of Chushinguro, the telling of that story through the eye of a fantasy that's grounded on Japanese mythology.
It's big. It's got great themes like honor, revenge, love. My character is in love with the princess, but it's an impossible love. He can never be with her. She's taken away. She's in jeopardy.
From this moment on, you are banished from this land.
You are now Ronin.
It is time. Your world will burn.
It's a samurai film, but also fantasy.
Whatever happens, whatever you see, there's no coming back.
Your life belongs to us.
Then take it if you can.
Every country has the same spirit of samurai. Never give up.
We have the 47 against hundreds, and it's how we prevail.
We're not afraid of you.
You should be.
It's an epic, human, heroic story.
The world will know who we are and what we did.
"47 Ronin" is a world that you're being transported into. I think it's everything we intended it to be, to recreate feudal Japan.
We were very, very careful and obsessive that we were not doing a 47 Ronin American version.
The level of detail, it's insane. We have to design it from the shoes to the clothes to the makeup to the hair, and it's all got to work together.
Penny is fantastic. She is a force. She really took the assignment to another level, especially the female characters. Their costumes are like couture. She's taken the authenticity of the period, but put her own flair on it.
I just wanted to start with the base of the shape and then build onto it because we're making a fantasy film.
Two things that Penny were great about: strong silhouettes for each of the character designs and the color palettes and textures. Because what Penny wanted to do was really create a look for each person.
So we've done Akko, which is the happy place, in red. We've done Kira's world, which is the villain ugly place, in purples. And then the sort of godlike group, the Shogun, are golds with little hints of turquoise. Those three elements run through the whole film. You know immediately who people belong to by the colors they're wearing. We have stuck absolutely to how these things go on, which makes it very complicated because you can't do it yourself. You've always got to have help.
For instance, if you're wearing a kimono, right over left is how you always wear it. The only time you wear it left over right is when you're buried. If you tie your kimono in the front, it means you're a prostitute. So you have to be very, very careful about how you handle every little thing.
And action!
We're filming second unit at night and first unit during the day. So in any given day, we might dress 600 or 700. So they come off one unit, heavy armor, ripped off them and stick it on a different body. But the visual is going to look magnificent.
Your army is infinite.
We are 47.
We have the 47 against hundreds, which is great action. So there's some arrows, there's fighting, there's sword play. And there's been a real effort to connect the fights to story.
We wanted to get as much in camera as we could of the fighting.
It's not your father's samurai movie or samurai fights. I bring in this element of watching samurai, learning the Tengu sword techniques. You work high-low, go for the feet, try to get inside, and duck. Make sure you duck.
Keanu and I had a one-on-one fighting. It was a big fight. His style's more wilder and real.
Kai's more about attack. Elbows and knees. Punches. Scrappy. Win at all odds.
We wanted to show the contrast between his style and my style.
Sanada-san is playing Oishi's. High hand, high bar.
He's a master swordsman. In the historical attack of the 47 Ronin, they snuck in at night, and it wasn't a huge battle. What we wanted to do was something different to have a bigger scale to it. So we had everything from 47 men infiltrating a castle and fighting against hundreds, and then the one-on-one battles. It's real fighting and big action. When it came to the weaponry of 47 Ronin, Simon Atherton was an invaluable resource, and he made every bow, every arrow, everything you can possibly imagine, to the swords themselves, down to the finest detail.
It's been fun. We've made a lot of swords. We're probably up in the 600 swords now.
And he gave a personality to each one.
The swords are so iconic. We can't use original swords. They're so valuable. So we've bought some replicas and we've manufactured our own swords. The reference for swords is very well documented. A lot of the original blades were remounted on different handles and went to the Second World War, and I gather that the Japanese are still hunting for certain family swords.
From a physical acting standpoint, I started training basic katana. That basically has been the groundwork that everything else that I'm doing in the film is based on.
A bokken is a wooden training sword to represent the real thing. These are made in white oak. So this is a very blunt sword for training with. And in our film, we see fighting with bokken. Each samurai can have three weapons. He can have a tanto, which is a short little dagger. They would have a wakasashi, which is the short sword, and a katana, and the katana is the long sword. This is a tanto here. We've put lots of decoration on it. They were quite decorative things in the Edo period.
Those two fingers just there.
Simon Atherton took into consideration the real culture, and he tweaked it just a bit to make it his own.